Hey guys, I'm Pearl. Welcome to my channel. If you're new, thanks for stopping by and don't forget to subscribe. And this video is just basically to give guys a few tips on how to make protective styles work for you. I've been doing protective styles for a while now, so you know, I've learned a few things along the way that have helped me retain length over the years. So I just thought I could share those with you guys. So since I'm doing like a 6-month protective style challenge, I figured it would be a good idea to give you guys these tips, in the beginning. I would advise you guys to start off your protective style on clean hair. It doesn't have to be like day one hair. You could feel that your scalp and hair is still relatively clean after like 3 days. That's fine. You need to bear in mind, or you need to be really careful about the type of protective style that you select. In my case, I chose my protective style based on, just the ease, something that I can easily work with. So I wanted something that I can, still moisturize my hair, deep condition my hair, wash my hair without having to redo the hairstyle over and over again, because I tend to wash my hair on a weekly basis. So for me, it was between mini braids and twists. So if I want to keep my hairstyle in for a lot longer, I would use mini braids. But if I don't mind switching up my hairstyle on a weekly basis or every 2 weeks, then I'll consider doing twists, because I know that when I do twists, and if I were to wash my hair in twists, I'll end up with a lot more tangles and matting than I would, if my hair was in mini braids. So that's why my preferred hairstyle is mini braids, because I don't wanna like switch up my hairstyles as frequently. So I chose mini braids, and I chose to do my mini braids with just my hair only, because I don't want to add additional weight to my hair. And I've noticed that artificial hair tends to leave my scalp really, really irritated and itchy, which is just not what I want. So I'm not going to be using artificial hair, and artificial hair also tends to add weight, around the perimeter of your hair, because if you know that the hair around your perimeter is a bit more sensitive and a bit more fragile, so you need to be careful about how you're handling your hair. So I'm just using my hair alone. So if you're going to be using artificial hair, you just need to be really, really conscious of your edges and as well as tension. When I do my hairstyles, I don't pull on my hair tightly, because I know that excessive tension can cause balding, can cause alopecia, and that's not what I want. You don't need a tight hairstyle to guarantee growth, okay? Just because you're protective styling doesn't mean you should just forget about your hair for a few weeks, You still need to moisturize your hair, you still need to wash your hair, you still need a condition. So all those things also played a role in my choice of protective style. Because I can still do all these things to my hair in mini braids. I can still wash my hair. I can still condition and moisturize my hair while it's in the braids. That was another advantage, another plus for me selecting mini braids as my go-to hairstyle. Those are just a few things that I wanted to mention. And just so you guys keep that in mind during the course of, your protective styles. Anyway, so I just wanted to give you guys these few pointers just to help you guys out, and if you find it helpful, great. If not, just continue to do what works for you. I'll see you guys in another video. Bye.